Example 2, given the following function p of x equals negative 4 times the absolute value of x minus 2. Well, let's list in a correct order the transformations of the parent function. Well, let's first note to self, what is the parent function? Y equals the absolute value of x is the parent function. Now, there are two vertical transformations. One is a reflection and one is a stretch. So let's list those first. Two vertical transformations, a vertical reflection over the x-axis or about the x-axis. But really you can concisely just say vertical reflection. That's the negative in front of the 4. And then the 4 itself is a vertical stretch. And usually you say by a factor of 4. And then lastly, we have one horizontal transformation, and it happens to be a horizontal shift right. Remember, when it actually looks like x minus 2 on the inside of the parent function, then it is a shift right. So let's graph each of the function, let's graph each function using transformation. So start with at least 3 key points on the parent graph and show the corresponding points on the new graph. So what I'm going to do is first list, let me leave those visible, our vertical transformations can actually be combined to operate on the y with one step. So remember, we have the parent function y equals the absolute value of x. We're going to multiply the y values by negative 4, because we can combine those two transformations, the reflection and the stretch, because they're both multiplication and it does not matter what order you multiply, so we can do it in one step. And then we're going to add 2 to the x values. So we really only have two things to do. So let's go ahead and jot down the key points of the parent function. So the absolute value of x, remember those anchor points are negative 1, 1, 0, 0, and 1, 1. And we know this is a V-shaped curve because we're getting that memorized, right? And then where does negative 4 times x, the absolute value of x minus 2 end up? Well, we know it's going to be a V-shaped curve. It might be narrower and it might have shifted some, but it's going to look like a V. So what we're going to do is multiply all of the y values by negative 4 first. So I have negative 4 because 1 times negative 4 is negative 4. I have 0 because 0 times negative 4 is 0. And then I have negative 4 again because 1 times negative 4 is still negative 4. And then we're going to add 2 to the x values. So negative 1 plus 2 is a positive 1. 0 plus 2 is 2. And 1 plus 2 is 3. So once I get these points down, I'm basically going to connect the dots with a V, and then I'll see where p of x has landed. So 1, negative 4, be right here. Two, zero, and 3, negative 4. So this is p of x, and it is an upside down and more narrow V-shaped curve than the parent function, the absolute value of x.